joy or happiness, success or failure, peace or dismay. The foundations of our life rest on the words we receive. A word of hope and guidance, translated from the Temple of Solomon in Brazil. You're listening to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Univere Video is your platform for Christian content, and it gives you access to the church meetings of the Universal Church around the world, and they are in English. Even the meetings at the Temple of Solomon that provide live, simultaneous translations to English. All you have to do is sign up, and this is how. Visit www.univerevideo.com online or download the application on your mobile device and complete the simple registration form. Have your bank card ready and choose your terms of payment. And before you know it, you'll be up and running. Stay connected to the things of faith during the 21 days fast of Daniel.
Look at this field of wheat. It's certainly one of the most beautiful scenes we could ever imagine. But don't fool yourself. In among the wheat, tares are also growing. Can you tell them apart? To the naked eye, it's almost impossible, because as they grow, they are identical. This is why, in his parable, the Lord Jesus taught his disciples that only time would show the true identity of each one. Let both grow together until the harvest, and at the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, first gather together the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barn. That's when we see the difference. When wheat is ripe with fully formed grains, it bows down with the weight of its grains. But the tares, which are poisonous, produce no grain and do not bow down. Instead, they are clearly seen among the stalks of wheat because they stand up straight. This is the time of separation. The tares are pulled up, and the wheat is gathered into the barn. When we look at a crowd of people in a church, everyone appears the same. They all pray, sing, raise their hands in worship, and even speak of the things of God. But only those who are born of the Spirit have fruits of righteousness and bow down, like the wheat, before the will of God. But Christian tares are proud and do not accept discipline. They do not bow down, but stand up straight because they like to appear holy while their inner selves are full of poison. It will always be this way. Wherever there is wheat, there will be tares, to confuse, to poison, and if possible, to even cause the wheat to be pulled up and thrown into the fire. Only time will reveal what is inside each one. When we go through battles and deserts, when we are shaken up and even crushed, we reveal who we are inside. If we are wheat, fruit appears and remains. But if we are tares, we will refuse to bow down and reveal our true selves.
Hello, my friends. God bless all of you. I would like that you would understand the Spirit, the Word which makes the difference in the lives of those who listen and practice. Not in the lives of those who do not listen and do not practice, but those who practice, those who obey, those who exercise that word, the word of God. It is as if they were obeying God Himself. God is speaking to them saying, do this and they do it. Do that and they obey. However, as God is Spirit, He does not appear physically to anyone to speak, nor does he use prophets. Although there are prophets, people who preach the word of God. A prophet is one who preaches the word of God, who teaches the word of God, who says what is written in the word of God, who echoes the voice of God, his word, through their mouths. So, when we preach the word of God, we are prophesying. Now, there is no prophet like a fortune teller. Not even in the biblical times when there was no written word. The written word. The word was only written by the priests, by the Jewish scribes. And at that time, only they knew how to read and write. They learned the word so that they may be able to write the message which God wanted. Moses, for example, was instructed to write the Pentateuch, meaning the five books, the first books of the Bible. So when this word is being preached, it's God speaking through that person. But it's that word which is written, not that word which someone says, no, look, you need to marry so-and-so. Look, you need to travel. You cannot travel. No, this is lies. It's from the devil. These types of prophecies are deceitful. It is used by the spirit of deceit. And many people, unfortunately, disgracefully, and even capable people, intelligent people, have been giving ears to these prophets. So the prophecy is the word of God. For example, Jesus spoke. Jesus said, for what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? He spoke. So Matthew wrote this. Matthew was a tax collector, so he knew how to write, and he wrote. Luke, the doctor, later, he converted and sought to know the life of Jesus. Mark as well wrote, and John, who walked with Jesus, also wrote. All of them were instructed. They were instructed. They knew how to write, and they wrote. When I speak, for example, I say, look, Jesus said that you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. So, I am repeating what Jesus said. I am not speaking by myself. I'm not teaching or sharing an idea which I received. No. So, I wanted you to know the following. What profit is it for a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? So, Jesus showed through this word that there is nothing more precious, more rich, greater than the soul, the human soul. So you can be poor, you can live in the slums, you can be the last of all creation on earth, but you have an incalculable, immeasurable richness. It's so great as my riches, which is my soul. So all humans carry within them a treasure which is immeasurable, infinite. They are so rich, it's so rich, it's so rich, which our soul is. Our soul. that the Lord Jesus Himself, the Lord Jesus, gave His soul to rescue ours. He paid the price for your soul, for my soul, with His own soul. So, when I speak like this, I am simply prophesying that which is written. I am repeating, because as God is Spirit, He speaks through His servants. So He uses my mouth, the mouths of other pastors, of other people, people filled with the Holy Spirit to speak of His word. And now the devil also uses people who carry the title of a pastor, a prophet, etc., to deceive people. He speaks a little bit of truth, but in the midst of the truth, he produces lies, as he, the devil, did with Jesus. He brought in lies within the truth, which he spoke to Jesus. It's written. He used Psalm 91 in an incorrect manner. He said, he spoke, more or less. He spoke a part which was true and another part which was not true. So, my friend, pay attention. Jesus said, what profit is it for a man to gain the whole world and lose his own soul? In other words, he's saying, prioritize your soul. Prioritize your salvation. What is necessary for you to give to have salvation? You need to give your soul. To give your soul is to give your heart. To place your heart on the altar. To detach your heart from the son, the daughter, the wife, the husband, the family. Detach your heart from this world, from riches, your reputation, your greatness, which you have. And place your heart on the altar. Submissive, humbly on the altar. Then the Holy Spirit will use this heart, this soul, to speak to other people who speak and give testimonies. Now, when a person does not give ears to the voice of God, spoken through his servants, then this person obviously does not believe. And it's what the Lord Jesus said to his disciples. Go throughout the world and preach the gospel to all creation. He who believes and is baptized in water will be saved. He who believes and is baptized will be saved. He who does not is already condemned, meaning the soul that does not believe is condemned. So I will not explain any further, because we keep explaining, trying to help people. But it seems the more we speak, worse it gets. So I will end up here. That's it. Take care of your soul. As the apple of your eye. Do you not take care of your eyes, you women? You put mascara, you put makeup, you spend time for makeup. Is it not true? Very well. Pay attention. There is nothing more precious in your life than your soul. Take care of it as the apple of your eyes. And you will see that all the other things will be added unto you. God bless you, and until tomorrow, in the name of the Lord Jesus, amen.
When I was 10 years old, I suffered from a sexual abuse by someone. And ever since that day, there was a change within me. I started to question God, why that happened to me. Inside of me, there was a void. There was hate, anger. I had anger towards my mom, my dad, because I blame it at them as well. I would tell God, God, just take my life. I can't take it anymore. I would go to sleep. Before I go to sleep, I'll tell God, just take me. Like, I'll be better with you than being here suffering. I keep blaming myself and everyone around me. I keep hurting myself, because no one was hurting me. I was hurting myself. Well, I became very, very rebellious. I would yell. I would talk bad to my parents. I would take it upon my brothers. I would take it upon everyone around me. I would hurt everyone's feelings. I was very prideful. I had a lot of anger. I didn't let anyone talk to me. I didn't let anyone get close to me. Once I got to high school, I had a lot of friends. I became really popular because I just wanted to keep forgetting everything. I would look for the friendship. And then I had a boyfriend at the time. I got with him, and then I started doing things that I wasn't supposed to do with him. I would go to parties. I would start to drink. And family parties, I would drink as well. I the alcohol got my attention. Then I turned into edibles because, I didn't like smoking. So I would turn into edibles with weed on it. One time I got really, really high. I don't even know what was on the thing. Ever since I got high that day, things became a lot worse. All that turned into anxiety. I had very bad anxiety. At nights, I would wake up screaming. I would wake up crying with panic attacks. It was very bad. There was nights I couldn't sleep all night. One day, my mother invited me on a Friday, and she told me to come. I came, so I listened to my mother. I went with her, and then she's like, "We're having a vigil. You should stay as well. It's gonna help you even more." So I listened to her. I was like, "Okay, I'll stay." I listened to the pastor, and I let everything out. I let all the anger, all the pain that I had towards this person. I let it out that day. All the anger. I let it out that day, and I told God how hurt I was, that I couldn't take the pain. I let everything out, and I felt so relieved after. I felt so relieved. I've never felt anything like that. I started to see the change. All the pride went away. I started to see that I was not prideful anymore. All the hatred, I didn't have hatred in my heart. All the sadness was gone too, and I became more happier. I had more peace. I started to see that I was no longer, I had the anxiety. I was able to sleep at night. I was no longer angry. Like, nothing would get me mad. Like little stuff that was so unnecessary. I didn't get upset. I started to talk to my mom differently. I started to have my mom. I started to have a full conversation with my mom. She became my best friend again after coming on Fridays. And then on Wednesdays, I came as well to seek the Holy Spirit. And then until one day, I received the Holy Spirit. I received a certainty of the Holy Spirit being with inside me. And it was this true happiness, true peace. I couldn't even stop smiling. I was smiling at everyone. I wanted to hug everyone. I don't know, I just saw everyone so differently. I saw everything around me differently with different eyes. It was a moment that I would never forget when I received the Holy Spirit. And then I started to see even a bigger change within myself. I started to see that I had, love for the souls. I started to show more love for my brothers because they would be like, "You don't even love me. You won't even hug me. You don't even look at me." Now they're like my best friends. Oh, my three brothers, they're like my truly friends. Like, we do everything together. We go out to eat together. We hang out together. We do everything together. And now with my mother, my father, I go out with them as well. We go out with the family. We go together to church. We do everything together now. And before, it wasn't like that. Before, I would be the one that wasn't even around them. Today, now I'm healed from all the trauma, from the hatred that I had against God, from the hatred I had against everyone around me. I'm healed from the depression. I'm no longer sad. I feel that void inside my heart. For you who's watching this program and that's been molested, has been raped, has been hurt by someone, I know how it feels. I understand that there's a void inside of you, that there's a pain, that you feel like you're alone, that I know it's hard. I know that it can hurt you. It could traumatize you. But I'm telling you that there is a God out there. There's a God that can truly help you, that can take away everything that you're feeling at this moment. Come to the University Church. I invite you. As I overcame depression, I overcame the hatred, the anger, the sadness, the void that I had inside of my heart. I overcame all that thanks to God, because He's the only one that can help us. He's the only one who can set us free from all the evil stuff that we have around us, inside of us.
The Helpline Call Center is open 24 hours a day, every day of the week, all year round. If you need help due to a serious problem you may be going through, if you feel that you have nowhere to turn to and desperately need someone to lend a listening ear, then we can help you. It doesn't matter who you are. or what you have done, your religion or race. Your call will be answered by someone who genuinely cares about you and have your best interests at heart. We also arrange home visits or the housebound and hospital visits for anyone in great need of kindly human contact. Whether it is simply information you want or desperately need someone to talk to, we're here for you.
Thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known.